Hello and welcome back, everybody. My name is Josh Jepson, but you knew that already. Today, we're back in Pterodactyl Land. That's weird, right? Didn't we like do this level or something? See, this is why I love when you guys leave me comments, because you tip me off to things sometimes early enough that I can actually do them on camera that I didn't think about or have never done before. I think I've done this once a long ass time ago, but I was tipped off to a way that we could feed these poor Oogle Boogles early. Although we will be able to feed them really soon the way you're supposed to, but we're gonna do it now. We're gonna do it right now. And then we're gonna do some stuff in Witchy World as well. But I think we'll do the Oogle Boogles first because that's, ouch, that's what is required. So the goal here is to head over to Al and Salty Joe, Big Al and Salty Joe, get loaded up on some heckin' god dang, whatchamacallit, fast food situation, get some McDonald's, some Wendy's, nuts. And we'll go from there. We'll go from there. It is nice to be back in Witchy World. This is the next level that I want to backtrack to also. So, like, this is kind of convenient to do this all at once, to be honest.
I've got no more burgers left. Better run around for some more. I think there's one just under your left foot.
I wish I could skip this dialogue because I've literally seen it before. But you cannot. Oh, we should pay a visit to Madame Grundy just once. Just to see if she gives us the one cheat. The Jiggy get Jiggy cheat. Come on, Grunty, get jiggy with me.
Oh, welcome. I will now choose your fate. You win a beating. Fuck you.
Well, no get jiggy cheat for me today. Maybe we'll try again in a little bit. We'll go through it a couple of times, see what happens. Actually, this is a great opportunity for me to do this because I need low health for the next step. What's up, buddy? Give me some fries, Joe. Yeah, fries coming right up.
Have a nice day.
Yep, me too.
I don't know why I'm giving Kazooie his voice now.
Better start frying up some more because I'm all out.
Yeah, you'd better prepare for the impending rush. All right, now that we have some fast food, here's what we need to do. And hope that going into Madame Grunty's didn't screw this up. Kill me. End me. I don't wish to live in this world anymore. I don't like it here. I'm scared, I'm terrified. I just want the sweet release of death. We did it, hey, look at that. Coincidentally, this is the only exit in the entire game that you can take the food outside of Witchy World. Like if you go out through the main entrance, Grunty's like, you can't do that.
Me war, but still need food, junk food, good. Me need food, you got, you give?
Yeah, sure. Num num. Berg.
Mmm, that tasty, me all happy now.
You're welcome. He didn't even say thank you, actually.
Rude, dude.
What a rude dude. Can I even get up? Oh yeah, I totally can. Hell yeah. Your DoorDash has arrived.
Me warm, but still need food, junk food, good. Me need food, you got, you give?
Yes. This is from Five Guys. Oh, he's even got a little horn. Bro's horny now. I get it. I get it. It was the burger was that good, huh? I understand. I don't think I've ever had a burger that, like, made me feel something sexual, but, you know, I'm all for it for these guys. I love and believe in them. Here, would you like a fry? I brought fries also. I think I might be out of burgers, but you can have a fry if you want a fry. Yeah, there you go. Num num. Mmm,
that tasty meal, happy now. Bear and bird friends save Oogle Boogle tribe from extinction. Must have reward now.
Dude, honestly, I feel like you could have, like, traded that gold for some food somewhere. Right? Isn't that a thing? Why are there teeth marks on it?
Me thought chocolate was inside.
Hey, you know what? That's a fair assumption. That brings an interesting question. How come they've never sold chocolate jiggies? You know how they have the chocolate coins? It's just like chocolate covered in gold foil, you know, whatever. Why don't they just have the same thing, but for jiggies? I need a chocolate jiggy. So long as it wasn't like a Hershey's situation, because Hershey's taste bad. Like, I wasn't on board. Like, I remember, like, a lot of my European friends would say, like, oh, Hershey's tastes like vomit. And as a kid, I was like, I'll eat a Hershey. Why not? Sure. But as an adult, every time I've eaten Hershey, I'm like, I kind of see what the Europeans are on about. Like, they got the good chocolate over there across the pond. But Hershey ain't that. And that's the thing, is that so much of the chocolate comes from Hershey. But you know what? I'll still eat a Hershey's Kiss. I'll still eat a Hershey's Kiss. Okay, so what we need to do now, let me just see if I need to talk to Mrs. Boggy. Because we have the scoop, we can finish this quest and actually 100%. Witchy roll now.
I'd be awfully grateful if you could find my children, Groggy, Soggy, and Mongy, and bring them back here to me.
So two out of the three children you can do when you first arrive here, but you cannot get the third one without the scoop. So now that we have the scoop, let's go looking for them. I don't remember where they are. Two things are going to complicate this, finding where they are. One, I had to restart the game anyway, so they might move depending on like the save file. But also, I think they move every time you reload your save. Like, I have a sneaking suspicion. Okay, sometimes there's one over there. Sometimes I think there's even one inside here. So I'm going to have to, like, just be checking all of the locations. Yeah, see? Yo, what's up, dude?
This fair is so much fun. I'm not going to make it back to Mother. There's nothing you can do about it. Oh, this place is great. I'm never going back to Mom.
What if I lit you on fire? Oh, I didn't. That wasn't the fire mood.
Oh, what did you do that for, mister? I'm off to find my mom and she'll tell my dad.
Dude, your dad doesn't even give a shit about you. I'm just saying. There's nothing that your dad, like, your dad does not care, I promise you. Which is so sad. Boggy is a terrible father. And he remains a terrible father in this game. He's the worst father in the franchise, hands down. Like, Bottles, okay, dad. You know, he plays sports with his kid. You know, he's usually there for his family. He comes home for dinner every night after playing poker, except for one night in particular, for no reason in particular. You know, like, shoot, who else is a dad in this? There's other dads, I know there are. God, Mumbo's probably a father. How many children do you think Mumbo has fathered? Hopefully zero, really. Hey, can't you read, Furbag? All food must be consumed in the theme park.
That's not fair.
Of course it's not fair, but try and leave with that stuff you've got and I'll take it off you.
Good thing we're not going on the train. Aha, the culprit.
Thank goodness you came. I'm really hungry.
Don't you think you've had enough?
No way, I just need a burger before I go find my mom. Oh, you've got some burgers. Please, 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 can I have one? Will you give me some food? Yummy.
gluttony. My tummy hurts. I tried to burp, it didn't work. No, I'm not surprised. Okay, so now you can see where the trouble comes in, where we need the scoop. He won't leave without the scoop, so we have to bring the scoop to him. I also need to find the girl. I don't remember which one is Soggy, Groggy, or Moggy. I think Moggy is the girl, maybe. So we'll find her real quick, and then we'll come back for the scoop, and he'll be the last guy. At least all of the first locations that I've checked are where the bears are. She's not in here. She's not in here. That is so upsetting. I was almost 3 for 3 in finding the bears. She could be over here, I suppose. No, I think she's always in front of the... Okay, that's okay. We'll go look at other locations where she might be. Not outside Wumba's Wingum. Space Zone, I already checked. Behind the big top tent, world entry and exit. Man, where else can they appear? Unfortunately, I think they can appear at the end of the creepy tunnel. Which doesn't bode well for me. I don't know why I went to here. Yeah, I think they can appear at the end of the creepy tunnel. Which is like, I gotta go through a whole thing. But I don't know if that's just the one. I think they all can appear in any of these locations, right? Oh, wait, maybe it's in. She's in the space zone. I think that's more likely since we already have one in this zone. I think that's probably why subconsciously I went to the space zone to check. Because you can check, because one of them appears in the star spinner. And I think usually they're spread out into different areas. Like, oh, wait, because there was already one in the space zone. Then where might she be? Maybe that's not the case. Maybe she can appear in here. I'm hoping. I'm praying. Oh, she is. Thank God. Yo, girl, go back to yo mama.
Oh, I'm starving. Give me some fries and I'll leave quietly. Wow, we've got fries. Can I have some? Can I? Will you give me some food?
Sure.
Hey, thanks, mister. I'll go see if mom is ready to leave.
I do love that they gave Soggy, Moggy, and Groggy a little bit more personality in this game too, because like in the first game they're just like there, and you know Boggy's a bad dad, and you have to go and like get their Christmas presents for them or whatever. Well, their dad like lays sick on the ground from eating a Jiggy. What an idiot! What a dumbass! What a grand poobah of idiots! There's a lot of dumb characters in these games, though. I think that's why I like it so much. They're all quirky. They all have their own problems. They all have their own quirks. Issues to work out. Okay, I need a split pad, and the closest one should be in here. Although, it might even be easier to go to the big top 10, but we're already here. So I can get Scoop. Scoop the Scoop Taxi. All right, let's go, Banjo. Do your thing, girl. Dun, 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 dun. Boom, boom, boom. Man, we need a Boggy redemption arc. We need people to like Boggy again. He's a polar bear, man. Like, they're going extinct. Global warming is coming for his ass. He needs to, like, be liked, you know? We should be supporting the polar bears. But it's hard to when they're so unliked. Ew, gross. Get in the bag. You nasty. You nasty. All right, let's see if we can get all the way back there. Might be worth warping back, I guess, instead of walking the whole way, but man, it's so weird. Like, it really is like when you do have to carry something across the world without Kazooie, it is pretty obvious how big some of these worlds are. Because at least you have Kazooie to go a little bit faster. I remember when Nuts and Bolts was first announced and coming out, one of the reasons why they said they started doing cars as like a concept in the first place, which obviously evolved into like this whole thing and made it the whole point of the game, was because they made the worlds too big. And they're like, well, how do we get around these worlds faster? Give them cars. That's not a bad reason, but also like, I don't know. Do you need to make the worlds bigger every time? What did I tell you about not running off?
I'm sorry, Mom.
Sorry isn't good enough, young man. You've been eating again, haven't you? Well, you'd still better want your dinner.
It was that strange bear, Mom. He made me eat his burger.
Don't you remember me? I helped you in the first game, bro.
What a betrayal. Oh, child abuse. Just some casual child abuse. Maybe they're both terrible parents. Damn, no wonder these kids are so poorly behaved. Bye, then.
Thanks again, Banjo. Take this Jiggy. I found the ticket in the ticket office earlier.
Oh, God! There's an earthquake! What's causing that? She's just running, causing an earthquake. 49 Jiggies, looking solid. Now, let me run through my memory banks and see if there's anything else that we can backtrack for. There is. There is one more thing that we can go backtrack for in Jolly Roger's Lagoon. This is going to be the backtrack episode. We're just getting lots of that stuff done. We'll probably barely start Witchy or not Grunty's Industries, but I am looking forward to it. I'm warning you now. I'm going to say this, and I'm going to say it again when we start it. I'm warning you now, I will get lost in Grunty's Industries, and I'll be happy for it. There will be a point where I'm like, ah, oh, shoot, I was supposed to go here first, and then, like, I didn't, so We'll see what happens. Cause I am a little afraid. Just because it is a very complicated, it's like a vertical maze. It's like a series of vertical mazes trying to navigate that place for the first time. But once you open it all up, it's really cool. I think that's the biggest barrier to entry in that level. So I'm looking forward to doing it regardless. Plus it's also been like a long time since I played this full game. All right, world entry and exit. We're gonna head over to, can we get there from this level in some way? Jolly Rogers? I don't think you can. So we'll just have to warp. We'll just have to warp there. It's fine. No burgers, no fries. I wanted a road snack, you know? It's okay. Back to Cliff Top. Did we ever unlock Hailfire Peaks? I keep forgetting that Hailfire Peaks even exists. I'm like, oh, I'm gonna do Grunty's Industries and then the final world of the game. That's not the case at all. There is another world in there and it's Hailfire. So at some point we're gonna have to open that up. And, but we won't go there for a while yet. Grunty's Industries is clearly next. So, here in the town square, we're gonna split up. And it's time to send Kazooie on a mission. Fortunately, I think I've already opened up this area. Another thing that the commons let on about is something that we can do here too that I'm gonna try. That I don't know if I've ever tried. Hi! Wait, hold on. Let's kill this guy. He's just going to come back, but I don't want him bothering me. Hi, Tip Top. How's it going? You all right?
Still no sign of him hatching. I'm getting more worried by the minute.
How do you know it's a him?
It had better be. I've already got 19 girls?
Jesus. Okay, well, how are we going to hatch this egg? Are we going to use the hatch move that we got? Or can I just blow it up with grenade eggs?
What are you doing? That's no way to open an egg. You'll blow my little one to pieces.
I mean, it's kind of too late. Can I set it on fire? That does nothing. We're cooking it. We're cooking. We're having turtle soup tonight. I'm sorry. Listen, you've already got 19 kids. What's one? What's one turtle omelet? It's fine. Is there anything else I can use to attack this? I'm just kind of curious. Maybe I can throw a grenade or a Kazooie at it. No, it does nothing. Okay. Okay, that is funny though. I don't think I've ever done that. Let's just use the hatch move. You're welcome.
Oh, look at the baby! Oh, look at the baby! Look at him go! Thank you so much.
Wait. Something looks odd.
Oh no, he's upside down.
You mean he's tipped up? That's not funny. It really actually kind of is. Here, let me help out.
Oh, that's much better. I found this buried in the sand, it's yours. Now come along, son. I'll take you to meet all my somethings.
Man, I feel like while we're doing this backtracking stuff, I feel like I should make one attempt at trying to get the jiggy in that like inside cave lagoon area, because you can get it without the later move, I've been told. So I think I might give it one try, and if I fail it the first time, we'll just give up. You know what they say, if you fail once, just give up and never try it again, because you're a failure. That's what they always say, you know? That's the common phrase. So I'm told you need the running shoes. I'm gonna totally screw this up because I'm gonna forget the order of which I need to do this, because I think it's run. It's very, very tight. It's run. Wait, what? It would not let me flap while I was in the running shoes. Do I have to turn the running shoes off? What? Maybe I can just do it without the running shoes. No, okay, never mind. I don't know what I did wrong there, but it did not let me flap or attack or do anything in midair with the running shoes on. Unless I was screwing it up somehow. But I don't know how, like, if you were to turn the running shoes off, how that would add anything to your speed. So I don't see how that would help. Anyway, we're going to be getting that move sooner than later anyway. All right. Let me think. So any more backtracking? So we've got Pterodactyl Land. We did that. We did everything that we can do in Jolly Rogers currently. We did everything we can do in all these other levels. Witchy World is complete. Let me take a look at my totals real quick, actually. Still missing a Jinju and Alohags. I know where it is, though. It's actually in this location, but I can't get it just yet. Mayhem Temple is done. Glitter Gulch Mine is done. Witchy World is complete. Jolly Rogers is missing two, but we know which two they are. Pterodactyl Land is missing one Jiggy, and we know what it is. And that's it. Wow. Cool. So we are on to Grunty's Industries next. Let's freaking do it. Let's head back to ye old wasteland. The wasteland. Man, could you imagine like a creepy post-apocalyptic Banjo game? Like Banjo plus Fallout. Somebody needs to mod some Banjo-Kazooie stuff into Fallout to get me back into Fallout. No, I've been thinking about Fallout a lot lately, actually. There's the Fallout TV show coming. There's some Fallout mods that I've been interested in. I never did finish Fallout 4. I never finished that game, even on my own time. I never finished the game. So like, these are all games that I feel like I should like revisit at some point, you know? But I don't know if I'll do that on this channel because I feel like, you know, like my niche has sort of evolved into just like 3D platformers. And that's sort of the YouTube meta right now is... Jinjo? Jinjo? That Jinjo up there? That Jinjo looking pretty sus. I killed him. I killed him in cold blood. All right, everybody, welcome to Grunty Industries. The main entrance is locked. How could this be? What, pray tell, do we do? Okay, so we cannot go through the entrance. This is the thing that stumps a lot of people. So in order to do any of this, first of all, we need to not throw ourselves into the poison, the death water. Ah, hello, friend. Need to not throw, I said not throw ourselves, not throw ourselves into the, I'm really playing with fire here. Ow. No! Rude. God, I love that deep, hearty laugh, that belly laugh from the thing that's in the death water. This is the thing that stumps a lot of people. Because you have to come back here and open up the train station and actually access this level via the train, which I think is a really interesting way to start a world. Like this tells you that Grunty Industries is a different level than any other one before it. Like a lot of the levels in this game feel a lot more like Banjo-Kazooie levels, if that makes sense. This is the one, like the first one in the game, in my opinion, that feels no longer like a Banjo-Kazooie level and wholly a Banjo-Tooie level on its own. This has just is so far disconnected from everything else. Like, I feel like Atlantis sort of touches on that a little bit, you know. I feel like the theming of like Witchy World and even like whatever, like Jolly Rogers in general is very Banjo-Tooie-esque, but it doesn't quite do anything super, super different. And then, you know, Pterodactyl Land, I feel like, goes back to its roots. Even it's like a giant Banjo-Kazooie level. It's very similar in a lot of ways. But in this case, Grunty Industries takes the cake for the most unique, well, maybe not the most unique level. The last three worlds in this game are all very unique in their own special ways. But I think that this is one of the more interesting directions to take and very much reflects the darker, more industrial tone of Banjo-Tooie, which I did not appreciate when I was a kid. I definitely hated Grunty Industries when I was a child. It was just too overcomplicated, very, difficult to get into and understand. And I wasn't a big fan of the industrial feel, darker tone of the game. Now, as a grown adult, and I can look at it with a little bit more of an objective tone, objective view, I mean, Grunty Industries became one of my favorites, I think. So, like, and we'll see. Like, I'll probably get fucking annoyed in a second here. I'll probably get hella annoyed once we get in there, but, you know, I think they're some of the most important locations in Grunty Industries. And also, like, the fact that it sort of lends a bit of credence to Grunty being just evil. Like, oh, she's the CEO of a company that, you know, probably produces, like, a bunch of carbon whatever. Like, Grunty is actively trying to kill Boggy and his family. This is, you know, this is evil. It's evil. We hate her. We hate her even more now. She's a corporate overlord. So let's go into Grunty's Industries. It does feel really cool to be, like, infiltrating Grunty's, like, not her secret hideout, but, like, this is part, like, this is very closely guarded for Grunty, you know? The front door is locked, it's guarded by a guy. You can only get in by sneaking in via train, which makes sense that a train would go in there, because, yeah, I mean, how else is she shipping her products? Who knows what she makes here? I guess we'll find out. Here we are, officially. Oh, watch out for these guys. Oh, these guys are terrible. Ouch. Okay, these guys are terrible because, and I'll show you why. If you blow them up. Oh, actually, maybe not. I think if you blow them up while they're chasing you or, like, try to attack them, they will spit out, like, a noxious gas that will follow you and drain your health or drain your bubbles or both. And it's just a lot, man. It's just a lot. Before we get too deep in here, let's jump up. But yeah, this is the official time for chat. By chat, I mean comment section, to sound off in the comments on why you like or dislike this level. Give me some really good specific reasons. You know, I've already heard a few of your opinions, but now is your chance to really let loose and tell me your true, deepest, darkest thoughts on this level and why you hate it or why you like it or why you're indifferent on it. Because, you know, I have a lot of thoughts and I'll share them as we go. But yeah, it's a very unique level. Oh my God, we've got these security cameras. Watch out for them. If they spot you, they start spitting out these guys. You can blow them up. Like, there's this little pod that comes out and shoots these guys out here that will attack you with zappy zaps. But, you know, be quick in these rooms because just like every other enemy in the game, those spy cameras will respawn and then you'll be, like, in the middle of the room getting zapped by dudes suddenly. I think the first and foremost thing that we should do is, well, we'll probably learn that move. For the suction boots. What are they called? Man, we are at the point of the game where I'm just like, my brain, it don't process a single thing. But this is the move here. Yo, what's up, Jam Jars? Claw Clamor, that's what it is. Wear these boots and no more falls as they let you walk up walls. Let me tell you how it's done. Kazooie's footprints up you run. That'll be all. Dismissed. See you, Jam Jars. Thanks, bud. We love to see it. But, like, there's even, like, this elevator shaft that lets you get to every floor of the level. But each of the floors are locked. Like, it's, like, high security. So it's almost like this, I don't know, it's like this spy movie thriller where you're just, like, trying to sneak into a place. You have to unlock the main entrance, sneak in via the train, and then you have to, like, unlock every floor and, like, sneak around in vents and all this crazy stuff. And that's why I appreciate this level so much. It's different, man. You don't just have free reign of the whole level, pretty much. You know, you can go to Pterodactyl Land, and the first thing you can do is fight Terry, you know? That's the first thing you can do. Go get the move that you need, and then go fight Terry. And then that's it. There's so much to do immediately, whereas this, you sort of have to follow a set path. Up. Okay, good. That was close. Oh, I didn't open this door. Should I have done that? Can I break it and fall in, maybe? Hell yeah, I can. I'm a pro. Oh, this is interesting. This is a jiggy that they expect you to get later, but I'm gonna go ahead and get it now. Now, there's two ways you can go about this. You can either use just Kazooie and do like a flap spin jump thing to get over there. Or if you're feeling real crafty, you can throw a little fella over there and blow them up. And then once they all come out, you can just use grenade eggs. And if you have the homing cheat, which I don't currently have, which I really should probably go and get, I think I can probably get that now. Because you have to wait till they're open. There we go, there's one. They got a big old hitbox though, don't they? Of course, getting the jiggy is gonna be a pain in the ass. I think I'm probably gonna have to come back with just Kazooie to do this. But I'll do that real quick. Oh wait, no, I can get it with the Clockwork Kazooie egg. Should be able to, right? I can jump that high. Right? Right? Oh, look at, he's trying his best. He's trying its best. Poor little fella. Oh no, buddy. Buddy! Oh no! I can't even see it. Okay, no, I'm gonna have to get it with Kazooie. I don't even know if I can make that jump. We'll just jump down here. And then we'll switch over to Kazooie. Do the same thing again with the claw clamber boots. Just go up. And then, like, the goal is flap, spin in the midair. Maybe spin and then flap? And then spin again? Oh, that's what it is. Spin, flap, fit, spin. Because I did it wrong in Jolly Rogers, that's what it was. It's spin first, then flap, then spin again, because you can keep the momentum going in midair to get all the way up there. And maybe you can spin in midair while using the shoes, maybe? I'm not sure, okay. Ready, jump, spin, flap. I didn't even need to spin again, just a simple jump and spin. Was good and a flap. All right, guys, that is gonna be it. In the next video, we will continue on through Grunty's Industries and really get to the meat of this level and try to make as much progress as we can without getting lost. Wish me luck. Sound off in the comments down below about what your opinions are of this level. And thank you again for supporting on Patreon. I love your faces, and I will see you in the next one.